Hello, my name is Keshwani.
This is K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I, Keshwani.
We are here because we want to prepare for the TEAS. We have been solving math problems out of this book here, the TEAS manual, the 6th edition. If you do not own this book already, purchase one immediately. You're going to need it. Today we'll solve problems dealing with the concept of order of operation. Order of operations, something that we did yesterday on day number 107. We did 5 problems. We're going to do 5 more today. And if you decide that that's not enough for you, and if you decide that you need more practice with this concept of PEMDAS, the order of operations, you will find that we have solved every single math problems in the previous edition, the 5th edition. And you will find the solutions to all the problems that appeared in this edition from day number, TEAS 5th edition, from day 1 through day 80. The only difference is that they have moved things around. So the concept that we're dealing with today, the order of operation, is the concept that was dealt the very first in this book, which is why you will find the solutions to problem dealing with PEMDAS on day number 1. On day number 1. If you need some more practice, just type in TEAS Day Math 1, Day 1, and it will pop right up. In addition to that series of TEAS, we also have other series that we can take advantage of. You have other series at your disposal if you want to learn some more, if you want to improve your math skill. There is a series called Basic Math. Just type in Basic Math Day 46 or Day 47 and you will find even more problems dealing with the concept of PEMDAS. Let's get going, shall we? We're going to pick up from where we left off yesterday. We did the first 5 problems, first 5 examples on page number 68. We're going to pick up from number 6. We are on page 68, number 6. 150 divided by 6 plus 3 times 8 minus 5. 150 divided by 6 plus, if I read it correctly, 6 plus 3 times 8 minus 5. Let's see what we can do. But the very first thing we have to understand is the order in which we are supposed to do. And the very first one tells us that we have to take the parenthesis first. Parenthesis first, then the exponent, then the multiplication and division, and then addition and subtraction. Multiplication and division have the same preference, they have the same importance. Addition and subtraction, they have the same status, same importance, same preference. So then the question is, which one do we do first, addition or subtraction, if we are given a quantity which involves both addition and subtraction? The answer is, in that scenario where you have an expression which involves addition and subtraction, in which case the rule is that you must go from left to right. Same thing with multiplication and division. Left to right, if it involves both multiplication and division. But first thing first, we have to take care of the parenthesis first. But in the parenthesis, so this, you have to treat this thing as a separate quantity by itself. If you look at this quantity by itself, if you look at what appears in the parenthesis just by itself, you have to do this part. Okay, listen very carefully. So in the parenthesis, we have 6 plus 3 times 8. This is what we have in the parenthesis right here. Which one do we do first here? Well, in this quantity, we're supposed to do multiplication first because it appears first. So let's do that first, okay? So we have a parenthesis here. So what we end up here is, we're going to do the multiplication first in the parenthesis. So what we end up here is 150 divided by, open the parenthesis, 6 plus 3 times 8, which is 24, close parenthesis, minus 5. Take down the 150 again. Make sure you do one step at a time and make sure you rewrite your numbers. Line them up properly. Now we do 6 plus 24, which is 30, and then minus 5. Now we have to do division first, because division comes before subtraction. So now we have to do this first. 150 divided by 30 is 5, and then minus 5, it looks like the answer is going to be a big fat 0. Not an ordinary 0, oh no. We never have an ordinary one, a big fat one. One that needs to go on a diet, a big fat 0. Number 7. Example number 7.
Example number 7 says 36 minus 6 over 12 plus 3.
Oh, what can we do with it? What can we do with it?
What? 36 minus 6, we have to take care of the denominator, numerator first, which is 30, and 12 plus 3 is 15. We do the bottom, and that's it. 30 over 15 is just 2.
This problem that we just did, by the way, is the exact same problem as the one I'm about to write, which is
36 minus 6, and then we have 12 plus 3, and we're supposed to divide, top quantity is supposed to be divided by bottom quantity. So here we have a division, but because of this, because it appears as a fraction, that tells us that we must do this one separately and this one separately,
which is what we did here. And had this problem been given in this form, the answer would have been the same. We would have done the parenthesis first.
36 minus 6 is 30. Division sign. 12 plus 3 is 15. And 30 divided by 15 is 2. It's the exact same problem.
Let's do number 8. Number 8. Number 8, 9, and 10 are bonus problems. They are not in the book. The book only has 7 examples. 8, 9, and 10 are not in the book.
Here's number 8. 7 times 6 divided by 3 times 2.
Well, we talked about it yesterday. We had a long discussion about it yesterday as to why multiplication and divisions are put together in a box and addition and subtraction are put together there. Because multiplication and division, they have the same preference. Listen very carefully. They have the same preference, they have the same status, they have the same stature. Same thing applies for addition and subtraction. If an expression involves additions and subtractions, question is, which one do I do first? They both have the same status. They both have the same significance. But then which one do I do first then? But in that case, the convention, the rule is that, the rule of the game is that,
we must go from left to right, strictly from left to right. That's it, that's the rule. Strictly from left to right.
That's how we're supposed to go.
Because this problem involves nothing but multiplication, division, multiplication.
And multiplication and division, they both have the same preference. Which one do I do first? Well, go to left to right. That's what we're going to do.
So we're going to go strictly from left to right. So we're going to do this part first. 7 times 6 is 42. Then the division sign comes down. And then the 3 times 2. Again, go left to right. It makes think this thing, 42 divided by 3.
42 divided by 3. How much is 42 divided by 3? Don't look at me. How the hell do I know?
Look at it. 42 divided by 3.
How many 3's does 4 have?
4 has 1 3. 4 has 1 3.
After we take away 3 from the 4, we have a remainder of 1. That 1 goes and joins the 2, becomes the 12. And 12 has 4 3's.
In other words, 42
divided by 3 is
14. So this part, 42 divided by 3, gives us 14, and then the multiplication sign.
Always write like that. Notice how I line up my 2's and I line up the division. Everything should line up.
Don't write them everywhere, all over the place.
Don't start adding 14 times 2 over here. But line them up so you know you're not making a mistake, that you're doing the right thing.
That's it. That's your answer. Now we do 14 times 2, which is 28.
The answer to this problem is?
Answer to this problem is 28. Now, let's do question number 9. Question number 9 says, 7 times 6 divided by
3 times 2. Do you see any difference?
Of course not. It's the same exact problem.
It's the same exact problem as number 8, but it's going to be different soon.
Now, watch what happens now. Question number 9 is like this.
This is a very different problem. This is a very different problem than what we just did. With no parentheses, we go strictly from left to right. Here there are parentheses. We have to do the parentheses first because that comes first.
And it will give us a different answer.
We'll do 7 times 2, which is 42, first.
Then bring the division sign. And then we could do 3 times 2, which is 6. And 42 divided by 6. The answer to this problem is 7. Answer to the previous problem was 28.
As you can see, there are different answers. There are different answers because there are different problems. Which is why we have the conventions, which is why we have the rules, so that everybody follows the same rules and arrives at the same answer, so that we can understand each other's work. And the rule is that if you have parentheses, if I wanted you to do that first, if I want you to multiply 7 and 6 first, I would have told you so. And how would I have told you so? How would I have told you do that first? I would have told you so. And my way of telling you that, if I wanted to do multiplication, I want you to multiply. If I wanted you to multiply 7 and 6 first, I would have told you so by putting a parenthesis around it. If I wanted you to multiply these two first, I would have told you so by putting a parenthesis around it. If I don't put parenthesis, then I'm not telling you which one to do first. Well, then the question is, which one do you want me to do first? In which case, the answer is simply go from left to right. It's understood. The default is go left to right, unless I tell you to do something first. And how am I going to tell you to do something first? By putting a parenthesis around it. But if I don't tell you anything, just go from left to right. That's the rule. Let's do the very last one, number 10. Again, I'm telling you one more time, reminding you that these problems are not in the book. 8, 9, and 10 are bonus problems. They are not in the book. It says 3 times 12 divided by 6 times 3. Again, the same exact situation. We have an expression that involves multiplication and division, they have the same preference. What am I supposed to do? Which one do you want me to do first? Go from left to right, that's the rule. Go strictly from left to right. 3 times 12 is 3 12s are 36. So we get 36 when we do these two first. You get 36 from doing these two first. Bring down the division sign. Bring down the 6. Line them up properly. Multiplication sign. Line up everything properly. Now we do this. 36 times 6. Because again we go from left to right. 36 times 6 is 6. Times 3. And the answer is 18.
We have some problems that you see on page number 68. The practice problem on the side in the margin. Which we'll do tomorrow in the next video. On day number 109. Today was day number 108. And this, I don't know if I mentioned this in the beginning or not. I believe I did mention it. But one more time, in the event that I did not, if you want to practice more on this concept or any other concept, you will find the solutions to all the math problems from the fifth edition on day number 1 through 80. T's, fifth edition, day 1 through 80. That's where we solve all the problems that appeared in the fifth edition. There are no videos from day 81 through 100. They do not exist. We started a new series from day 101 for the 6th edition. The 6th edition begins at day 101. The 5th edition ends at day 80. I know.